My favourite part of Sagrada, I think, is simply that it is one of the most beautiful buildings in the world.
It is a beautiful, beautiful space.
The advice I give anybody to go to Barcelona is buy a ticket and go inside.
Inside of the Sagrada is marvelous. It's a forest with the sun, with the
magical light, with the most uplifting set of columns and structures that you'll ever get the experience to inhabit, to be part of.
The Basilica has 138 years old because began 1882. The first architect was Francisco de Paula Villar. 1 year later started the construction due to difference with the developers. The project was given to Antoni Gaudí.
At that time, Gaudí was only 30 years old. He hadn't constructed anything beyond a glove stand at the World's Fair of 1878, so he had no track record. So how they chose Gaudí is another puzzle, you know, mystery in time. But Gaudí had no lack of ambition, and he designed a church that was more than twice as tall as the one that Villar designed. And then Gaudí died in a horrible tram accident. So the first thing is that the design of the church wasn't actually complete. But interestingly, right now, it's a wonderful sort of irony, or not irony, the opposite, fortuitousness, that the technology available today exactly corresponds with Gaudí's design ideals. So in short, we can now use machines controlled by computers to cut stone to exactly the shapes that we want them to be, including cutting out pockets and holes using CNC techniques. So we've got bandsaws to cut the shape. But we include the love of craft, which I think is another wonderful aspect of Sagrada. So we computer control, cut the stones accurately, and then finish them the way they always have been, which is hand splitting the front face. So there's 3 inches or 75 millimeters of spare stone, if you like, on the front when the computer's finished with it, which is all dealt with then by hand. So that in the end, the building looks exactly as it would have done if it had been built in 1200 or 800.
Obviously, the project is not finished by Gaudí. And unfinished, approximately, we have 55% of the basilica is remained to construct. It's possible to do 55% in 7 years? Yes, because we are using the new method, we are using the industrialization of the process, we are using the standardization of the different methods to construct the basilica. For this reason, using the new technologies, is possible to achieve, to reach this milestone, this challenge.
So when we were appointed, asked to help in 2014-15, they'd set themselves a deadline of 2026 to complete the church, 100 years after Gaudí died. And they had a puzzle that they wanted our help with. They thought the solution involved designing steelwork. In the end, that turned out not to be the case. So there's a set of 12 Apostles' Towers, four at each entrance. The east entrance, the side entrance, was built during Gaudí's lifetime, four Apostles' Towers, or bell towers. The next set of four were built on the other side, on the west entrance, the Passion Facade, in the 50s. Both of these are built using conventional monumental masonry techniques, no different from what would happen in medieval cathedral buildings. All of that was well and good until the church was listed by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. And one of the requirements of the listing was that we made sure that any future construction was earthquake proof. So the puzzle was, how do you solve that? The solution that we found through a lot of sort of technological investigation, using computers a lot, you know, let's forget steel and let's even forget concrete for a moment. If we go back to stone, the original idea of the church, how can that be used to make a tower that is lightweight, that is fast, and is earthquake resistant and wind resistant? And also the idea of this from a construction strategy can be largely prefabricated off-site so that the site activity is minimized so it can occur in and around the day-to-day tourism activities of the church itself. And every surface of Sagrada in its final design is a ruled surface, a hyperboloid or a hyperbolic paraboloid. These are doubly curved surfaces, but they also have one set of straight lines that define them. They're very hard to make, actually, using reinforced concrete, even in precast form, because all the formwork has to be curved and it has to be cast accurately, etc. But interestingly, right now, they're relatively easy to make using stone, because we can have computer-controlled bandsaws that can cut any shape you want under the control of a computer, provided it's a ruled surface. Using our computer studies about how stone actually works, and we found, of course, that it does have this weakness that it can't carry tension. What we then found is that if we can pre-compress it, if we can clamp it together in some format, then you end up with a very good structure without using very much stone. And the easiest way to provide the clamping force is to thread very thin pieces of steel through the stone and then tension them, tighten them up. So they're acting just like elastic bands holding the stone together. And now we've got a panel that is rigid and firm and stable that we can take to site and use like a Lego block to add to all the other panels and continue to make a tower that looks as though it is monumental masonry. I've worked on many buildings, and there are buildings where there's more of me in the outcome, if I can put it like that, where I've had more of a hand in shaping the concept. At Sagrada, the concept's already shaped. Gaudi shaped the concept, you know, before I was born. And so our job is here in interpretation and maintaining quality and making it, you know, possible, if you like. However, despite that, I think it's the project that I feel warmest about. We've got the beauty, in my view, of using a natural material. Increasingly, the world has to use more natural materials. At least we have to use materials that have less carbon embedded in them. Otherwise, we've got, you know, climate change is bad enough already. So we've got to do things that are more sustainable, and stone is, you know, one of the potential solutions to that. And then on top of that, we have the craftsmanship angle of using people and love and craft in a time-honored way, which again is carbon-free, to add, to gain a whole layer that, from which people respond emotionally. So people respond emotionally really well to natural materials and to craftsmanship. And the technology sort of sits almost invisibly in the middle to make it all work at a speed, you know, that's relevant and at a price we can afford. And so for me, I think the thing about Sagrada I really love is this. Even though it's a very, very special building, the philosophy or the way we are doing it is something that you can extrapolate to almost anything. We can start making more buildings out of timber using computer-controlled machines to cut and make timber accurately, and to use more prefabrication off-site to make site construction easier. So there are things that we can learn from all of this as well.